Hello everyone. So today I'm going to show you how to make this character, this NPC character, look at the player as you can see in this demonstration. So as you can see, the NPC character, we have given the player as the target for NPC to follow, and NPC keep looking at the player using only the upper body, as you can see here, just like player look at the direction we look through the camera, turning his upper body. NPC looks at his target, which is player at the moment. So if the player goes to the back of the character, the NPC simply turns around so that it can keep looking at the player. Like this. So he will continue to look even when it is in the move. Alright, let's see how to implement this. And this episode is sponsored by these generous patrons. Thank you very much for the support you guys are giving me. Right, so at the moment, this NPC character, it can follow me, but it doesn't really look at me. So it would look much realistic if this character keep looking at me while he was following. So what I'm planning to do is, as you can see here, I have a look at system. So to make the player character look at the direction I am looking through the camera, like this. So we can, it doesn't, player don't turn around 180 degrees if the angle is higher than 90 degrees from his front, but if the direction I'm looking at is within this area, player looks at like this. It can look up, it can look down, it can look this way and that way. Okay, and now let's see how to implement, how to add that to the NPC character, where he will look at, not the forward, he will look at the direct, the character this guy is currently following. Right. So if I go, let's open the NPC character. And this looking at part is implemented in the animation blueprint, if you remember. It is implemented in this AO look. This is just a aim offset asset we have implemented to make the character look at, turn his upper body and look at the directions we want. So we control this that aim offset asset using this yaw and pitch angles variables, and I update them in where, here in this part, update AO parameter. So here what we do is we get the base aim rotation. What this returns is the aim rotation for the pawn. This is a default, this is engine function. This is not a custom function that I have created. So that is by default the pawn rotation for AI, and camera rotation for human players. So we need a way to, instead of using this get base aim rotation, we need a way to get the rotation towards the target AI character is following. So how can we do that? Right, so let's, here this is, let's go to the parent character, which is third person character, and here in this PI character movement. Let's replace this get base aim rotation with the custom function so that we can override it and make it return the target rotation, the target look at rotation for NPC characters. So actually at the moment I have only this PPI character movement interface. Okay, let's looking at is also kind of similar to movement, so therefore because I don't feel like adding another different interface for this function only, so get look at rotation, and it should return a rotator. Now in here, let's return get base aim rotation. So because for the player we only need to return the control rotation, actually this one also returns the control rotation. Why don't we just return get control rotation? Why not? Let's see if the player look at part is still working. It is working. Can look up, can look down, can look left, can look right. Awesome. Now let's override this function for the NPC character like this. Override where is it, get look at rotation. So here if we have a valid target actor, because if the character is currently not following any of the characters, it should not return try to return the look at direction towards this character. If it is valid, we need to find look at rotation from this actor, get actor location from this actor to the target actor. Get actor location, current actor's location, and the target is get actor location of the target character and return it. If not, return get control rotation. I don't see it is working. I didn't replace the function yet. Get look at rotation. Okay, now see the NPC characters keep looking at us. Let's reduce the acceptance distance radius for the character, because it always try to always moves too close to the player. Let's keep something like 500. See, it looks at the character like that. And if I go behind him, he don't care, he just looks forward. So that's also kind of a natural behavior. But if we want, we can make the character turn towards our direction, but I don't think at this moment I don't need such a functionality. Right. Actually, let's try to implement that turn in part as well. This is the turn event. This should be here. Oh, we can't search where I have called it, because turn is a substring of this return, and therefore everything shows up. So this is turn in place, right? So let's change place. Now we call it here. Okay, so right, so then in the same place where we calculate the turn, we have this. Okay, speed values, right? If the character is not moving, so we can get we can get the velocity. And get vector length. Can we directly get the speed? No. Okay. If this vector length is larger than 0 or less, that means character is working. And also, if this yaw, so this yaw will be larger than 90. Plus 90 or less than minus 90 if the character is out of if the target is out of the range that the character can see. So if this one is larger, absolute value, the reason to get absolute value is because this could be the positive 90 or negative 90. So this one, and character is not moving, because this would be a problem if the character keep start to turn while it is moving, at least for the player character. Well, let's first implement this without considering that part. Branch, if this is larger, that means character is out of the view range, then character should turn in place. So yeah, actually this is a in place turning, that's why I told I mentioned before it could be a problem if we call this function while moving. So right or left, if this If the value of the yaw is larger than 0, that means right. Otherwise, it's left. Right. See. Let's move somewhere. Okay, right. The problem with the player is player also turns to the direction we look through the camera, and because of that I can't walk back while moving while I look the behind the character from the camera. I can't move, so that's the problem with player. So let's move over here. Okay, now let's try to go behind the character. Now see, the NPC is turning to our side. Let's disable this for the player turning part, otherwise it is hard to test. It's player controlled. It should be a knot. Right, now we can move and while looking at some other direction. Okay. Right, so this is what I wanted to implement, and it is working. All right, so I'm gonna stop this episode right here. And if you want the enemy also, the NPC character also, to prevent turning while it is moving, we can, to this end, we can check if this is larger than 0 and connect it like this. But I am cool with this behavior, so I'm not going to do that. All right. So as always, project files will be available for the download through the Patreon page. Link would be in the description below. And thanks for watching. If you like to support my work, you can get the membership of the Patreon club. And see you in another episode. Goodbye.